A few days ago, it appeared that Nintendo made an FCC filing for a SNES controller for a Nintendo Switch. And when you look at the filing, it's unmistakably a SNES controller. This will be exactly like the NES controller we got a while back. And just like that one, it will only be sold to Nintendo Switch Online members. Sweet. This is pretty good news. We're finally getting another system added to the online service. But here comes the bad stuff. According to Dr. Oh my god, I'm sorry if I mispronounce your name. Dr. Sercantato. Dr. Sercantato. It should be noted here that months ago already, Japanese business publication Neki said it learned that Nintendo indeed plans to add more systems to Nintendo Switch Online. According to Neki, this would be combined with an additional pricing tier for the service. So you're telling me that the whole point for this service, being the cheapest one out there, is getting completely nulled. Though that depends on how much is the additional tier, if there even is any. If it is true then what the hell? Does Nintendo seriously think that they have value in their service? Let's have a look at their motto for Nintendo Switch Online. More games, more features, more fun. First off, where are the games? We've been waiting a good while for another system to be added to the service. But no, instead we get drip-fed NES games, 1 of 3 games a month. Like, are you kidding me? If you're trying to get people to stay on the damn thing, you should either have a good library ready to go, or give us more than 1 to 3 games a month. These are NES games. They run on an emulator. Why is it so hard to put games on the freaking service? If I am paying for this, and you even say more games, I expect more games. Second, where are the damn features? Yes, you did add cloud saves, but not every game has it. Especially the ones that need it, like Pokemon, Animal Crossing, or Splatoon. We poured time into these games. And we just want to back up our saves to make sure that we don't lose our progress. It sucks. It just sucks when we can't back it up. You may say they're trying to avoid cheating. Yeah, I know. But why can't they figure out a workaround to this issue? Every other company has been able to circumvent this. And Nintendo has the capital to do so. So no, there is no excuse for this. Another point of contention is the server issue, or lack thereof. There are no servers, and there is no better example than Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Well yes, some matches do run smoothly. Most of the time, it runs like garbage. This is because the game runs on peer-to-peer connections instead of a server. When a game runs on a server, you don't need to depend on the other person's connection in order to have a good playing experience. If you need an example of this, look at Fortnite. The connection is almost always smooth and responsive due to it running on a server instead of peer-to-peer. And hell, you don't even need Nintendo Switch Online to run games like Fortnite. This is just unacceptable. Third of all, more fun. Is it fun to be frustrated at a company that seems to be tone-deaf when it comes to this sort of thing? Is it fun to be frustrated at all the issues that were present since the launch of the service are still here? Is it fun that I just want to relax and play games, but instead I'm here talking about this again? I don't even know what to do. I'm getting so sick of this nonsense. I just want it to end. But if Nintendo keeps making mistakes, someone has to call them out. But then again, nothing concrete has been announced as of now. But if it does, well, everything I've said still stands.